Continuing the new separating wall down to the subfloor is a basic soundproofing principle that prevents noise passing under a wall system. If you're unable to do this, separating the floor so that it's not continuous under the wall system is an alternative. In new build properties, developers often install all the floors first using chipboard, then install separating stud walls between bedrooms and bathrooms. This causes massive noise transfer between rooms. Flanking noise through the loft. One of the best examples of flanking noise is in semi-detached bungalows when the party wall separating the two bungalows does not continue up to the roof. They share one big loft. TV noise can transmit up through the ceilings of the bungalows and down into the living areas below or next door. The neighbours have no privacy and find themselves competing on TV volume. Lofts present many flanking issues, which is why a cheap loft conversion can amplify and channel noise through the rest of the property. In most cases, it's not practical, even with all the persistence in the world, to continue a soundproofed wall system up through the bedroom ceiling and into a loft. We'll have structural joists and purlins in the way, or even a chimney stack. To reduce this kind of flanking noise, you have to try to continue as many layers up past the ceiling as you can. Then, in the loft above the ceiling, either continue the wall system up or insulate the entire loft. Remember, thermal loft insulation does nothing for sound attenuation. Acoustic mineral wool slabs cut and positioned between the joists, filling every void, would be better. You can, if you choose, put the thermal insulation back over the sound insulation, but don't block up the eaves or install acoustic mineral wool insulation between the rafters of the roof unless you've had a specialist's consultation and advice, as you could cause condensation.